Good morning, students. Explain in detail. In today's class, we'll see what do you mean by garnishee order. Okay, in the last class, we have seen this word garnishee. Okay, so here this word, ये जो word है garnishee, it is derived from the French, old French word garnir. Okay, garnir मतलब which means worn or to prepare. Okay, so it is to serve an hire with a notice. Okay, to warn certain debts that must be paid before the person is entitled to receive property as an hire. Okay, यहाँ पे क्या होता है, the court order instructing the garnishee, that is bank, that funds held on behalf of the debtor, that is judgment debtor, should not be released until directed by the court. Okay, जब तक court नहीं बोलता, they should not give any loan amount to that person. Okay, the order must instruct the bank to pay a given sum of judgmental credit, मतलब the person to whom a debt is owed by the judgment debtor, from this fund. Okay, let's see in detail what do you mean by garnishee order. Okay, a simple meaning about what is garnishee order. Now garnishee order is a order of the court. Okay, garnishee order मतलब क्या है, it is the order which is given by the court. Okay, it is obtained by the judgment creditor attaching fund in the hands of the third party who owes the judgment debtor's money. Okay, warning the third party to release money attached until directed by the court to do so. जब तक court नहीं बोलता, they should not release the amount. Okay, release the money. So the obligation of the banker to honor the customer's check is extinguished on the receipt of the order of the court known as garnishee order. अगर चेक आया तो बैंकर को जब तक कोर्ट का ऑर्डर नहीं मिलता है तब तक दे कैन नॉट पे द अमाउंट टू दैट पर्सन. ओके, दैट इज नोन एज गार्निशी ऑर्डर. इफ़ द डेटर फेल्स टू पे द डेट ओल्ड बाय हिम टू हिज क्रेडिटर, द क्रेडिटर मे अप्लाई टू द कोर्ट फॉर इशूइंग ऑफ द गार्निशी ऑर्डर ऑन द बैंकर ऑफ हिज डेटर. ओके, so there are two parts of garnishee order, that is order nishi and order absolute. Okay, now order nishi matlab kya hai, the first kya kehta hai, court kya kehta hai, directs the banker to stop payment after out of the account of the judgment debtor. Okay, then such order is called order nishi. ओके, यहाँ पे कोर्ट क्या करता है, दे आस्क नॉट टू पे एनी पेमेंट, नॉट टू मेक एनी पेमेंट, दैट इज टू स्टॉप द पेमेंट ऑफ द जजमेंट डेटर. ओके, दैट इज नोन एज ऑर्डर निशी. नाउ सच एन ऑर्डर सीक्स एन एक्सप्लेनेशन फ्रॉम द बैंकर एज टू व्हाई द फंड इज सेट सेड अकाउंट शुड नॉट बी यूटिलाइज फॉर मीटिंग द जजमेंट क्रेडिटर्स क्लेम. Okay, the banker is prohibited from paying the amount due to his customer on the date of receipt of the order nishi. Okay, so therefore the banker should immediately inform the customer so that dishonor of his check issued by him may be avoided. Okay, next is order absolute. ओके, यहाँ पे क्या होता है, बैंकर जो है, व्हाट ही विल डू, आफ्टर द बैंकर फाइल्स हिज एक्सप्लेनेशन. ओके, जब बैंकर जो है फाइल करता है एक्सप्लेनेशन की ऐसा ऐसा डिटेल्स है, देन इफ़ कोर्ट में इशू द फाइनल ऑर्डर विच इज़ कॉल्ड अ ऑर्डर एब्सोल्यूट वेयर बाय द एंटायर बैलेंस ऑफ द अकाउंट और स्पेसिफिक अमाउंट इज अटैच और हैंडेड ओवर टू दिस जजमेंट क्रेडिटर. ओके, अगर फॉर एग्जाम्पल आई विल गिव यू वन सिचुएशन. ओके, अगर कोई पर्सन है उसको पैसे भरने हैं, सपोज देर इज़ ए एंड देर इज़ बी, बी ने ए के पैसे भरने. ओके, तो बी का जो बैंक है उसको कोर्ट क्या करेगा, दे विल गिव नोटिस टू बीज बैंक कि स्टॉप करो पेमेंट. ओके, देन बैंकर क्या करेगा, ही विल गिव ऑल द डिटेल्स टू द कोर्ट, देन कोर्ट व्हाट दे विल डू, कोर्ट विल गिव द ऑर्डर टू द बैंक कि जो भी अमाउंट के पैसे है जितने उनके क्रेडिटर्स को देने, सपोज दे हैव टू पे 20,000, देन 20,000 ट्रांसफर टू द क्रेडिटर्स अकाउंट, मतलब जिसको पैसे पे करने, दैट इज ए के अकाउंट में पैसे ट्रांसफर करो, दैट इज नोन एज गार्निशी ऑर्डर. ओके, So here, on the receipts of such order, banker is bound to pay the garnished fund to the judgment creditor. Okay, therefore, thereafter the banker's liability towards the customer is discharged to that extent. Okay, the suspended account may be reviewed after the payment has been made to the judgment creditor as per the directions of the court. Next is attachment. Okay, so when a garnishee order is served on the banker, he should attach all the debts actually due or occurring due. The debts occurring due means the debt already incurred but payable at a future date. Okay, सो फ्यूचर डेट के दिन इसको पे किया जाएगा. सो इट डज नॉट इंक्लूड डेट नॉट एग्जिस्टिंग एट द टाइम ऑफ द ऑर्डर इज सर्व. ओके, अ कस्टमर अकाउंट इज ऑल्सो अटैचबल बाय द गार्निशी ऑर्डर. ऑल्सो ऑल्सो अ डिपॉजिट अकाउंट रीपेबल ऑन डिमांड इज अटैचबल बाय द गार्निशी ऑर्डर. नाउ there are different kinds of deposit that are attachable, that is deposit payable on fixed notice provided by the notice has been given by the customer before the order is received. Okay, then the deposit payable on fixed date in case the debt occurring due. Okay, so here banker ko kya karna hai, they have to stop all the operations of the account of the customer after receiving the garnishee order. Jab garnishee order mil gaya, then they have to stop all the operations of that particular account. Okay, सो इट मस्ट रिमेन डॉर्मेंट अंटिल द ऑर्डर इज रिसीव्ड. ओके, जब तक ऑर्डर गार्निशी ऑर्डर नहीं मिलता एंड जब तक उसका डिस्चार्ज नहीं होता, दैट टाइम ऑल द ऑपरेशंस विल बी स्टॉप ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर कस्टमर. ओके, द बैंकर शुड नॉट ओपन अ न्यू अकाउंट और ऑपरेट इट ड्यूरिंग द गार्निशी प्रोसीडिंग्स. ओके, न्यू अकाउंट भी ओपन नहीं कर सकते एंड कुछ जब तक वो गार्निशी प्रोसीडिंग खत्म नहीं होता, दे कैन नॉट ओपन अ न्यू अकाउंट और ऑपरेट इट. ओके, सो द न्यू अकाउंट इज नॉट अटैचेबल बाय द गार्निशी ऑर्डर एज इट इज अटैचेज ओनली डेट एक्चुअली ड्यू ऑन और अकरिंग ड्यू एट द डेट when the order is served and not the future debts. Okay, so in the case of limited garnishee order, when the sum attachable, okay, jo amount hai usko suppose they have to give a notice. Okay, before it is noted that before paying the amount in accordance with the garnishee order, the banker is entitled to deduct from his customer's creditors balance all the debts. Okay, jo debts hai usko कट किया जाएगा. देन वंस द गार्निशी ऑर्डर अटैचेस द बैलेंस स्टैंडिंग ऑफ द क्रेडिट ऑफ द प्रिंसिपल डेटर एट द टाइम ऑफ द ऑर्डर इज सर्वड ऑन द बैंकर, द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स आर टेकन इन टू कंसिडरेशन. देर आर सम पॉइंट्स दे हैव टू टेक इन टू कंसिडरेशन. दोज पॉइंट्स आर देन ऑर्डर डज नॉट अप्लाई टू okay the amount of check, draft, bill, etc. sent to for collection by the customer which remains uncleared at the time of the receipt of the order. okay, so isko nahi apply hota hai. second point is the sale proceeds of the customer securities, example stock and shares in the process of sale which has not been received by the banker. okay, so these are the two points where they have to stop the garnishee. Even if they receive the garnishee order, they cannot stop this operations. Okay, next is write a detailed note on termination of relationship between banker and customer. Okay, कब there will be termination of relationship between banker and a customer. Now this is what stoppage of the account. Okay, account को operate करने से stop करना, that is known as termination of relationship between banker and a customer. Now this term defines the term becomes rather difficult because it is impossible to include all the functions performed by the banker in single definition. Okay, especially the modern banker who discharges large variety of functions cannot be defined in few words or sentences. Okay, so even in England there is no statutory definition of the term banker. Okay, banker ka koi term nahi hai. So therefore some leading authors on the banking law have tried to define the term from time to time on the basis of decided cases. Okay, So the banker customer relationship is established by mutual agreement between both the parties, which can be discontinued by mutual agreement only. Now what do you mean by mutual agreement? Okay, now if there is any differences arise between banker and a customer, okay, in their dealings with each other, okay, then customer may want to have want some special services which the banker is not willing to give. Okay, agar koi special services hai and banker doesn't want to give to that particular customer, okay, jaise ki customer drawing check on the banker without any fund in his account, okay, or giving check or bills for collection to the banker on which there has no legal rights, okay, or deal with the bankers in manner which may put the banker in difficult or risky situation, okay, in that situation banker won't accept whatever services are there, he will stop giving that particular service, okay. So here in the above circumstances, what happened, it is better to terminate the relationship. So if customer want to terminate the relationship with the banker, he gives a written notice to the banker about it, okay. If he has a current account or a saving account with the banker, it can be closed immediately, but if he has a fixed deposit account, it cannot be closed, only on the expiry of a particular period of a fixed deposit, okay, it can be closed. So in case the banker want to close the customer account, he sends a written notice to him, okay. Yahan pe kya karenge, they will give a written notice, okay. So once the written notice is given to him, if the customer does not disclose his account after the receipt of the notice, the banker will send him a check for the full amount of his account, okay. In the case customer does not encash the check, the banker will continue to honor the check drawn on the account till the funds last, but not accept any deposit of his account, okay. This is the first way of the termination of the relationship, that is by mutual understanding. Second is by giving the notice. Now banker should give a reasonable period of notice to his customer to close his account, okay, so that the latter may be able to make some arrangement regarding business he is dealing, okay. So in case of foreign customer, more time should be given, okay. What a reasonable period of time depends on the nature of the business of the customer and other circumstances. So Prosperity Limited has started an insurance scheme which has many participants, has deposited premium money by the Lloyd Bank, okay. After some time, banks gives 1 month notice to Prosperity Limited to close their account. So it was held that considering vast business of Prosperity Limited, 1 month notice was not reasonable notice, okay. So yahan pe depending on the business also, they have to extend the time of the notice. This is the second way to terminate the relationship. Next is by the death of the customer, okay. As soon as the banker receives the information about the death of the customer, his account should be closed, okay. No payment should be made from such account. So even check written before his death but presented after, it should not be honored. So after the death of the customer, his legal hirer inherits the right of his account, and the bank has to act in accordance with the instruments after the legal hirer has obtained a succession certificate from the competent court. Next is insanity of the customer. Suppose if the banker has to close an account, if he hears that his customer is insane, okay. So but his account can be reopened when he declares to be normal by the competent authority, okay. So your banker, however, has to be very cautious because it is difficult to ascertain whether the person is really insane or not, okay. Next is insolvency of customer. Now there are some cases when the customer is not able to pay off his debts, okay, that is known as insolvency. So here the account of the customer should be closed as soon as bank gets the information about his insolvency. So such account may be operated only under the instructions of the receiver or administrator appointed to handle the affairs of the insolvent customer, okay. then is winding up of a business. So in case there is, if it is a partnership business which is dissolved or company is liquidated, okay, the banker on receiving the information of such dissolution or liquidation, they have to close the account of that particular partnership business. Okay, so this account can be operated only under the instructions which are given by the official liquidator appointed by for the liquidation process. Okay, अगर वो इन्फॉर्मेशन मिला ओनली देन दे कैन डू दैट. नेक्स्ट इज असाइनमेंट ऑफ बैलेंस कस्टमर्स अकाउंट. ओके, इन सम केसेस कस्टमर क्या करते हैं, मे असाइन अ क्रेडिट बैलेंस टू हिज कस्टमर टू सम अदर पर्सन एंड मे गिव अ नोटिस ऑफ सच असाइनमेंट टू द बैंकर. ओके, आफ्टर द रिसिप्ट ऑफ सच नोटिस द बैंकर विल नॉट हॉनर द चेक रिसीव और द क्रेडिट बैलेंस इज असाइन or up to the extent of the balance assigned. So in such cases, part of the credit balance is assigned, the relationship between banker and the customer is not terminated, and the banker may honor the check on the remaining part of the credit balance on in its customer's account. Next is garnishee order on the customer's account. So if bank receives an order from the court to stop payment from the customer's account, that is garnishee order, the banker must not honor the check drawn by the customer on such account. Okay, so if the order is to attach the whole balance in the account, the banker can honor no check to of its customer. So if on the other hand the order attaches a part of its balance, check may be honored only up to the amount that will remain after the garnishee order has been enforced. So the relationship between the banker and the customer is re-established after the garnishee order is lifted by the court. Okay, jab tak garnishee order ka process chalu rehta hai tab tak kya rehta hai, there is a टर्मिनेशन ऑफ रिलेशनशिप. जब वो गार्निशी ऑर्डर का जो व्हाट यू कॉल स्टैम्प है वो निकाल दिया जाता है, तब उनका फिर से देयर इज री एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द रिलेशनशिप. सो दीज आर द वेज ऑफ टर्मिनेटिंग द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन बैंकर एंड कस्टमर. दैट इज फर्स्ट इज म्यूचुअल एग्रीमेंट, सेकेंड इज बाय नोटिस, थर्ड इज बाय डेथ ऑफ कस्टमर, फोर्थ इज इंसेनिटी ऑफ कस्टमर, fifth is insolvency of customer, sixth is winding up of business, seven is assignment of balance in the customer's account, eighth is garnishee order on the customer's account. So these are the ways of terminating the relationship between the customers.